on the line with us tonight, and you know, he was the star of this past weekend. I think doing what a lot of people didn't expect him to do, and that's annihilate and do something nobody has ever done before, and that was defeat Robert Guerrero in the fashion that he did. We're welcoming undefeated former WBC World Lightweight Champion Omar Figueroa. Welcome to ATG Radio, champ. First off, congratulations on the big win this weekend, man.
Yes, sir. Thank you for having me.
Michael Doss.
Man, I, just like Frank said, congratulations for one and for another. That was a tremendous fight. You know, one, in my opinion, one of the at least top five of the years. You were going for it. He was going for it. Were you surprised, with how aggressive that Guerrero came out, or were you expecting that?
No, like I said, that was actually kind of part of the game plan, because we knew that he had a lot more riding into this fight going in than I did, so we knew that he was going to come out firing the way he did, and we're just gonna weather out the storm and wait till he gave us an opening.
Those uppercuts, man, I got to commend you. Me and Elliot were talking about that earlier. Some of the craziest stuff, and you never would have thought that Robert Guerrero would have fell for them uppercuts. Is that something that you've seen watching video of Robert Guerrero, or is it just something you just, you tried out, it worked, and you kept on trying it?
Well, it's something that I did a lot before of, because I like to fight on the inside. So, being that my coach is Joel Diaz, and he's had a lot of experience with inside fighters, we practice uppercuts a lot because that's my style. I like to be on the inside. I like to be banging, and I like to be trading punches. But my coach also did bring it up that, he was more susceptible to uppercuts than normal. So we try to make that part of the game plan. And like I said, it just worked out.
Well, just a couple hours ago, it's starting to get announced on all the boxing websites and all that. Robert Guerrero officially retired about 2 hours back. Did you read up on that? Did you know about that yet?
Well, I heard about it. I was, my PR girl Hannah texted me, and she let me know that Robert had announced his retirement, which I was hoping he did. I mean, not that I, like I said, I have the utmost respect for Robert, and I appreciate everything he's done in the ring. As a Mexican, as a fellow Mexican, I have nothing but admiration for the guy. But the way I felt him in the ring, I don't know if it was just me or if that's just, I have no idea, but the way I felt him in the ring, I was hoping that he retired.
Okay. I'll tell you what, a lot of people were kind of shocked. I kind of figured it was going to happen, but after the fight, you announced that you're going to go back to 140, try to fight for another title or get your title back. Is that something you've ever been planning on, or did you kind of make that decision after the fight the way you felt?
Well, we actually planned on going all the way back down to 140. It wasn't until mid-camp that we were told that maybe we should make a pit stop at 147, test out the waters, see how I felt there, have a fight, whatever. And so I was like, okay, that sounds like a good idea. I don't have to go back all the way down to 140. I can hang out at 147 for one fight, see how I feel, and, test out the waters. And I wasn't expecting Robert Guerrero to be the first name to be brought up to me, but it was. And me being me, I was glad that I was having such a challenge as my first fight back. It made me work harder. It brought back the jitters, the nervousness, the adrenaline of being back in the ring. And I hadn't felt that in a long time. I was finally injury free. I was healthy. I was excited. I was anxious, and it all worked out.
Well, speaking of 140, is my last question. I'm going to pass everything on to Elliot Vasquez after this. But, you're fighting in 147 pounds, one of the hottest divisions in boxing. you know, you say after the fight you had the biggest win of your career, you know, pretty much, and you go back, you're saying you're going back down to 140, which is kind of a, you know, not really a huge division. There's a lot of talent, but most guys are going up. I mean, you got Crawford and, you know, Joyce and Gogo fighting for all the belts. You got Crawford already saying he's going to move up to 147. You know, would you ever consider going back to welterweight here pretty soon, or are you just going to, you're not really following the money, are you just following your, you know, what your body's telling you?
Well, I'm not following anything. I just want to win the title at 140, and once I do, then maybe I'll move up to 147. But, you know, I know that most of the talent, at least the talent that's known, is at 147. So obviously, that's a division that I want to try my luck at. But as of right now, I do want to win a title at 140, and I'm going to do that.
Anybody you're targeting, man?
No, it doesn't matter. I'll fight a, you know, a tune-up fight at 140 just to see how my body feels at that weight, and then maybe, you know, hopefully challenge for a title to fight right after. But other than that, I don't know what my team is planning. Like I said, I just take care of fighting. I mention things to my team, and they do all the rest. So, like I said, you know, I mentioned to them that I want to win the title at 140, so hopefully they make it happen soon, and then I'll move up to 147.
All right, champ. Well, congratulations again. I'm going to pass you to Elliot. Elliot, go ahead, boy.
Thank you.
Hey, Omar, congratulations on a, you know, awesome victory. It almost looked like you never left. You know, 20 months is a long time to be out of the sport, let alone, you know, go to a weight class that you was never in. So I'm just going to piggyback a little bit off of Doss. I mean, what would happen if you said you wouldn't go back down to 140, but what would happen if you know, you get a phone call saying, can you fight us now, you know, for a chance for one of the champions or something like that? Because I'm thinking that with that victory, you have to be now ranked at 147 in one of the major sanctioning bodies. What do you think?
Well, I mean, like I said, I do my job, which is to fight. I let my team handle the rest. If the sanctioning bodies want to rank me in whatever their bodies is, then that's great. I'm happy, but I don't know. I feel like it's too soon for me to want anything or for me to expect anything. I'm letting it ride out. I'm letting my team do what they're going to do, what they're best at, and we'll see what happens, you know, what unfolds in the next couple weeks, couple months, and we'll go from there.
All right.
Well,
give a shout out to your fans, man.
I'm sorry?
No, I was just saying to, you know, give a shout-out to your fans.
Oh, well, definitely, man. I mean, there's no better shout-out to my fans than me winning in that fashion. That's for them. This is all for my fans. This is all for the people that believe in me, the people that supported me, the people that have had my back. You know, that I do what I do because of them. And so, you know, obviously I want to thank them for having my back and keeping up with me even after this long layoff. I want to say thank you for having my back through all this time that I haven't been active. You know, I'm not very active on social media, so even more so I commend the fans that stick with me. So, again, thank you guys for everything. I appreciate it.
Omar, I want to say welcome back, man. I want to thank you. I know this is like family time. This is chilling time. You kind of want to get boxing out of the system for a couple of days, but we appreciate you. You make us look good, man. I think you were the star of the weekend. And thanks for coming on here, rocking with ATG Radio.
Yeah, no problem, man. My pleasure.
Hope to have you on again, man. We'll get you. We'll bother you in a couple more weeks, man, once you get rested and get back in the gym, man.
Yes, sir. Sounds good.
Thanks, champ. You have a good one. God bless, bro.
Thanks, Omar.
Yes, sir. Likewise.
Thank you, man.
Thank you, Omar.